Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals. And on today's video, we're gonna do something different than I've ever done before. We're actually gonna take some samples of gold ore, this quartz gold ore, and we're gonna slab it off with this demo saw here. And some of you guys may be asking, you know, what's the point? Why would you wanna slab up gold ore, just crush it? There's a couple different reasons. The first one, as far as gold prospecting is concerned, is once you slab it up, you get a nice, fresh, clean face that you can do some mineral identification, you can look for free gold, you may be looking for what the gold is associated with as far as other sulfides or minerals. So you can learn a lot about your ore by getting a nice, fresh, flat, clean slab. And I actually have a little microscope that we're gonna take a look through later and do some mineral identification with. The other reason is the decorative stone industry is huge, and this rock is probably worth way more as a decorative stone than the gold that's in it. And so you'll see once I get it all slabbed up that it's got this really nice sulfides laced through it, and people will pay a really high premium for stuff like that. And I've seen them rock samples and slab samples for sale in some of the local stores around mining areas, and they're going for a huge premium just so people can, you know, own a rock from the old gold mine, or have a rock with a little piece of gold showing in it. So that would be the other option, where you can actually make specimens out of some of your gold ore and sell it on eBay or online or in the local shop. So that's kind of why we're doing it. But let's get the saw fired up. It runs with water, so it'll keep the dust down, so I'm not going to be breathing a bunch of quartz. But let's slab it off and try this out and see how it goes. I clamped it down to the pallet here. All right guys, so there's a slab off our rock. And as you can see, it's just full of sulfides and cool minerals. And so let's get it taken in and we'll take a look at it, get it cleaned up a little bit more, and see if we can see any free gold in it. All right, so here's our sample in a little better light, hopefully. And these are just laced pyrrhotite stringers in here, which is an iron sulfide. And up here, it looks like there might be a little bit of chalcopyrite. We'll take a look here in a minute. When I'm doing this, I like to have a little squirt bottle or spray bottle, because a wet surface is a lot easier to look at and identify than a dry surface. So you can just, I mean, it's literally just a little squirt bottle and just squirt it down a little bit, wipe it off the excess water, and then you can get a really nice look at some of those fresh sulfides. And here's this little microscope we're going to be using. It has a bunch of different power lenses, but we're going to use the 10 power. And when we look down through this thing, you'll see some dashes. And each one of those dashes is 50 microns. So it'll give you kind of a scale. And this thing is pretty cool. It's got just a flat bottom. You can set it right up on the thing you're looking at, focus it, and then you can get a really nice clear view of your rocks and your samples. So we moved outside, the lighting's a little bit better out here, and we got our focus. Like I say, each one of those dashes is 50 microns, and there's a couple things I want to show you here. This big gray mass in the middle, let's see if I can get my pointer in here. So this big gray mass right here is all pyrrhotite, which is an iron sulfide. And then if you look right over here, there's a little piece of free gold right there. All right, guys, here's some of my rocks I got cut up. I don't know, I've cut maybe 20 minutes or so. And you can see some of them are pretty wild. Lots of sulfides in them. Lots of mineralization. But, I mean, you can see how this could be really valuable to a collector or, you know, some of the locals who know about your local mine, or even on eBay. So you can find some pretty wild stuff when you cut open your rocks. So look at that one. That one's pretty wild. And I bet you can do some finish sanding, wet sanding, to get it polished up a little bit more and then put some sort of sealer on it so you keep that nice, fresh, wet look. But that's a really nice piece.
All right, and here's a really good example of the pyrrhotite on the lower right-hand corner. That's the gray, massive blob there. And then above it, that kind of brassy yellow is chalcopyrite, which is an iron copper sulfide. And a lot of times people mistake that for gold because it is yellow, but it has a much, much more brassy color to it than gold. And it's a very common mineral in ores, so it's one that's commonly mistaken for gold. But there's a really good example of both of them right next to each other, so you compare the color and the shape of them. Pyrite has a cubic structure, and that's FeS2. I haven't seen any pyrite yet, but if I see some, I'll let you guys know. All right, guys, well, this is the best I can do for focus and lighting, but there in the upper right-hand quadrant is a nice little piece of free gold sitting out there in the middle of the quartz. And I was looking all over the sulfide-rich stuff and trying to look around the chalcopyrite and looking for free gold. And because usually in ores, that's where it hangs out, is with the mineral-rich, sulfide-rich stuff. And here I found a piece sitting out in the middle of the quartz all by itself. So you never quite know where it's going to be, but when you find it, you know what it is. So that's pretty cool. And each one of those small dashes is 50 microns. And so you're looking at about a millimeter across for the widest cross section of that piece of gold. So that gives you kind of a size range and a reference on the size. So here's another shot, and there's a little piece of gold right up there. And there's a piece of gold right here, and there's some gray minerals associated with it here. There's a little bit of fine gold over here and a little piece up here. So the gold is really speckled all throughout this piece. Again, associated with those gray sulfide minerals of some sort. They look kind of like pyrrhotite, but they're a little bit too shiny and silver to be pyrrhotite. And they're not massive. In this ore, the pyrrhotite is pretty much massive and lots of grains, whereas this is just kind of little specks of the silver mineral. But let's increase the power and see if we can get a better look at some of this gold we have here. Here's a little bit higher power, and you can see that piece of gold. There's our gray mineral again that it seems to be associated with. And this is kind of a cool piece because the gold is flush with the surface on the left, and then you can kind of see it dive down into the quartz on the right-hand side. So that's pretty cool. Now, at this power, each one of those dashes is about 25 microns. So this piece across is somewhere in the 250 to maybe 300 micron range. And so, again, just giving you a size range. But there you can see another nice piece of gold in the quartz. And you can see it's not associated with any huge, massive sulfide or pyrrhotite. All right, so let's see if I can do this right. So if you get your cut quartz face, there's actually a lot of free gold right along in here. And if you get it oriented just right to the light, it'll flash at you. Let's see if I can do this on camera here. As I turn it, there you can see the gold. There's some up here. There's a pretty good sized piece there. And then the gray mineral that you can see associated with the gold. But there again, when you cut it, you can actually get a really quick and dirty visual on this stuff by just flashing it into the light just right. And it might be a little bit hard to tell in the video, but when you see it in person, it's really yellow. It is gold colored. And it's really hard to mistake for, gray sulfides or anything like that. Chalcopyrite's real brassy. This stuff is yellow, yellow, yellow. There's even some more up along over here you can see now that I'm looking. So that's just a quick little trick you can use to identify gold very, very quickly in your cut samples. And this isn't even polished. You can still see all the saw marks here in the right light. So it doesn't have to be mirror finish polish. This is right out of the saw. Here's another piece I'll show you that's pretty impressive. There's a little piece of gold here and some associated across through here. And then when you flash it into the light, it's still a little too wet. But so I've dried it off a little bit. You want it damp but not wet, because if you have a sheen of water on there, it'll reflect in the light. But let's try this again. There you go. You can see the gold. And if you go too far, you lose it. You just need that little reflective spot where the light's bouncing off those gold surfaces we cut, and it shows up really, really yellow.
All right, guys, so I hope you enjoyed the video today. It's a little bit different, a little bit unusual from what we normally do, but it was pretty cool cutting open these quartz rocks, checking it out, seeing what minerals we had in there, and also seeing some free gold today. And because this saw is gas powered and uses very, very little water, I think there's a really good chance that you can take this up to your mine site with a little water pump and cut open your rocks on site, and you can get some really good information identifying the mineralization you have, where the gold may be if you can get some free gold. Is the gold along the wall rock? Is it in the middle of the vein? Is it evenly dispersed? Stuff like that. And for all you rock hunters and specimen guys out there, this is a really good way to quickly identify which rocks may have some value for you as far as decorative stone or specimen. So what do you guys think? Is this gonna be a useful tool for you when you go out and prospect on some of your old claims and mine sites? Or is this really just kind of a novel thing that probably isn't very much use to the actual prospector or miner? So let me know if you guys find this stuff useful. Leave me a comment in the comment section below about what you think of today's video. And thanks again for watching. And if you have any questions or comments, you can find our contact information in the description below, or you can leave a comment in the comment section. So thanks again, and we'll see you on the next one.